Cinemark Theater is a perfect place to see this reimagined version of Child's Play. So when I was younger and I saw the first Child's Play, it's a great horror movie. It had humor, it had chills, but this new version, I feel like technology has caught up with this whole concept. And this is kind of plausible.
Right?
It's foreshadowing.
Oh, yeah. Sure. This is where we're headed.
Yeah.
Why do you,
you think Siri and Alexa are friends?
I mean, no. You're watching a movie, don't you think?
Well, there's so much gadgets and technology all around us that we rely on so much, and if it turned on us, there's really nothing we could do. I mean, and there's already machines that are creating smarter machines. So
exactly. Machines creating machines. Humans aren't needed anymore.
I think Chucky did something to her.
Sweetie, Chucky is a toy, okay? It broke, you got rid of it.
No, Mom, I saw him. I saw him following Doreen.
No, you didn't. Listen to what you're saying.
Mom, he's gonna kill her.
Chucky.
Why aren't you listening to me? I have it on Omar's phone. He's following Doreen. I can show you.
Why do you have Omar's phone?
I took it.
Why?
I had to. I had to follow Chucky, Mom.
Okay.
I'm not crazy, Mom.
Stay right here, okay?
So, not including Life After Beth, which is kind of a horror movie, but it's a comedy.
It's a comedy.
You know, this is more of a horror film.
Yes.
So it's a first for you to do like a full-on horror. It's the first time, you know, you're playing a mother. So how excited were you to do something like different and take on new challenges?
I was excited. I mean, I think when I read the script, I was so, I just loved the part because I just felt like, wow, I think it's cool that they're going to let me play like a young single mom. I think nobody really saw that coming. And my mom was really young when she had me. The age difference between the characters was the same with my mom in real life and me. So I felt very connected to the character. And then the horror movie of it all, I was never like a huge horror fan, but it's just such an iconic character that I just thought it'd be so cool to be a part of that franchise, you know?
How did you two bond, and how did you meet for the first time? I think it was like a special day for you from what I read.
Oh, yeah. We met during the audition process.
We did. You're right. Yeah. I was going to say, no, we didn't. We met on the plane.
Yeah, but then for the second time, that's when we really bonded for the
right,
first time.
That's
was on the plane.
That was. And it was your birthday.
It was my birthday. So she gave me a book as a present.
I gave him a book.
Yeah.
And he was sitting behind me. And he was asleep when I gave it to him.
Yeah.
I snuck it on his little tray, airplane tray.
How thoughtful.
Like a sweet mother would.
Yeah. Aww. That was, it kind of all declined from there.
Yeah, no. Then it got bad.
So, you know, you're making a horror film, and but, you know, you also want to have some fun. How did you have more fun, like, in between takes and joking around with each other, along with Brian?
Well, Gabe would trip me a lot. He would stick his leg out and trip me, you know, while the camera was rolling.
Well,
it wasn't rolling.
There was
that was fun.
A prank,
wasn't it?
Yeah, that was so fun.
Yeah.
It happened once on accident.
A couple times. It happened a lot.
No. There was a prank war that Aubrey started that kind of helped to bond.
I wouldn't say I started it.
It was your idea. I distinctly remember you sending me a text.
Cool.
To start it.
I can see this dynamic.
Yeah.
And the scares of this movie.
Right.
You know, that's what it's all about, right?
Well, we had to just keep the tension the whole time, you know? So we just devised different ways to scare the shit out of each other and
yeah,
just keep that momentum going.